Well, the moment has passed. Back to work!
G'day all, Mr. Paladin here. And today, I had to switch class. And it's not a big deal. What was happening was, as you can see at the top of the HUD, there was just way too many spies on our team. And even though, you know, I'm an effective spy, I can have difficulty being a spy when there's so many other spies around. So I just picked Engineer, and I just happened to be on the Gunslinger loadout, the Revengineer set, that I had recently done a video on. I didn't flick to any other loadout, I just went with what I had. Almost into overtime, pushing this cart up. But I just selected a loadout that I thought would be effective because Spy was not gonna work. But what I noticed in this game and in another game not too far from this one was that there are certain loadouts that for some reason the TF2 community just has a real knee-jerk reaction to. What I found in Team Fortress 2 games, particularly in casual games, for some reason there is a sort of acceptance by the community to instantly berate someone based on the items that they're using. Let me just list a few off. We could talk about the Huntsman, we could talk about the Blackbox, we could talk about the Backscatter, we could talk about the Sun on a Stick, we could talk about... There's a whole bunch of items. Some of them are just seen as too weak to even use. Some of them are considered to be, if you use this item, you're definitely got a crutch. Now, do not get me wrong. Some people absolutely use some of these items as crutch items. They are not effective unless they use these items, and so they have to use them as a crutch in order to help support their bad gameplay. That I completely agree with. That is without a doubt out there. But just because somebody uses this item does not necessarily mean that they are using the items as a crutch. So for example, let's just say that some engineers use the Gunslinger because they can't seem to maintain a level 3 gun, they can't move up their guns correctly, so they just dump the minis wherever they feel, and so it's a crutch item for them. The only way they can be effective as an engineer is to use a Gunslinger. The extra 25 health is just icing on the cake for them. Yes, that is true. That does exist, but that does not mean that every engineer who comes along using a Gunslinger is a crutch item. Are you feeling me on this? So let's take it the next step on, because this is where it starts to get really on my nerves, is that because of this, because there are some players who indeed use these items as a crutch, or they are crutch items for those people, there are some in the community that whenever anyone uses these items decides to start to berate them. And allow me to use a voice that I think best represents these people. It's like, oh, you can't snipe because you're using a Sydney sleeper. Oh, you can't be a good soldier, so you're using a black box conch. Oh, you're a bad engineer. Look at that mini sentry. Get a level 3, you noob. You know, I know that's not what they say, but they're basic examples. You know the examples. You've been in games long enough yourself to know this is the type of stuff that people say. And again, I even have to stress, this argument kind of does exist, but it exists for a different reason, because like, in different formats, like competitive formats, or formats where your teams are really working together, you really need your engineer or your soldier or, you know, fill in any class, to not only be using quite often the meta items, but to be using them very effectively. And if they're using them very effectively, it's producing a whole bunch of damage per second, right? It's optimal meta builds and stuff like that. And I see your Pyros, our medic is stressed, let me get you a dispenser. I really don't get people in casual Team Fortress. I mean, even the term casual is weird. It used to be quick play, they called it casual recently. Well, I say recently, but it's been quite a few months now. But Team Fortress itself as a mod for Quake has been around for a very long time now, and it's gone through its progression, you know. You went on to Team Fortress Classic after Valve purchased it out and stuff like that. So, casual was never in that game. It was just called playing the game, right? So I find it very strange in recent games to be playing a loadout, which was only introduced in Team Fortress later. It wasn't even in Team Fortress 2 when Team Fortress 2 came out. When it came out, they only had the stock loadouts, just like you still see in the console version of the game. By the time I got into Team Fortress 2, you know, I was kind of annoyed at Valve in the first place for taking a free game and making it into some sort of pay model, which was strange to me. I almost as a protest, I didn't start playing Team Fortress 2 right from the outset. But then I was at work one day and a colleague was, you know, we were talking about video games and the topic of Team Fortress came along. And then he mentioned, oh, didn't you know Team Fortress 2 went free-to-play? So I was like, oh, okay, I'll check it out again. Because, you know, I told him the whole backstory of how I wasn't fond that Valve had put money onto this game being, you know, it had always been a free mod for whatever other game that they had, and that was what they were using. But neither here nor there, it's history now. Loaded up, got my bronze mercenary badge and started playing some TF2, and you guys have seen the video history of all that. But what is present in Team Fortress 2, apart from all the other previous Team Fortresses, is this concept of loadouts, that you can change the weapons that you have based on a whim. I mean, it can be based on the map, it can be based on what your other teammates are using, it can be based on what the enemy is using against you. You can feel free to change to whatever it is you want. And somehow, that has changed into a channel or a means for people to berate you for the choices you make in regards to your loadout. And what seems the most odd to me is that you can have an effective loadout, like for example this Revengeer loadout. The items work together extremely well, unless you've burned to death on the cart, but they usually work together extremely well. The mini sentry gets a couple of kills and assists that builds up criticals. You're able to keep moving up with the team. The team pushes in. It gels together really nice. But because I'm not an engineer using a wrench, it's not the most powerful engineer build that you could possibly have. And therefore, you know, destroying your mini sentry to get the crits to move up the mini sentry can be something that people use as an avenue to berate you, when people should just be looking at the results. That I am here pushing a card in. Whereas before, I was the fourth spy on the team. You feeling me? Are you feeling me on this? So I went into another game after this one, and our team was losing. I think I was spy and also went a little bit medic in this round. I can't quite remember what I was before going soldier. But I just flicked over to a soldier loadout. The first soldier loadout I had was a black box conch loadout. Anyone who has played soldier for any length of time knows that this loadout is seen as a major crutch for bad soldiers, because bad soldiers can use this loadout to be effective. I'm using this loadout because if you look at the top of our screen, we're on a defense and we have no medic.
But Mr. Paladin, you could have gone medic.
Yes, yes, I could have gone medic. I could have also gone spy. I could have gone anything I want because it's casual. This is what it is. But in this particular situation, I chose to be a self-sufficient type soldier because I know I can get around and still help my team out. So here I am. That's how we got here. Like, record scratch? Yep, that's me. The black box soldier. Defending. Looks like I finally killed that enemy medic, who was doing very well, by the way. He was jumping around a few classes himself. But I see the need here. We really need to take out that sentry gun over the side. There's a teleporter with it, and that's really causing us a crunch situation here, because the enemy, even though we're killing them, is getting back so fast they're able to continue to push up the cart. Oh, good eyes, scout, seeing that I was up here. Make sure he doesn't reflect on that. The black box is very weak to reflects. You reflect one of these rockets, I'm probably not going to be able to kill you. And I'm probably going to want to back off, actually. So yeah, the black box, man. I was watching somebody stream, right? I was on vacation recently. I was watching a stream. And this guy who was a streamer, he liked to play soldier. But he threw on a black box. And he immediately apologized to the people who were viewing that he was using the black box. And I'm like, don't apologize for that. It's like apologizing for a loadout item. I get it. Some people use this item as a crutch. Some people cannot play a soldier unless they use these items. But just because you use said items doesn't mean it's a crutch. People just like looking for an easy way to insult other people online. It's really bizarre. So I comment to our spy, get rid of their teleporter. And then I look up and look at our team and realize that once, even though we had a bunch of spies, we no longer have any spies, so. But the point still stands, we really need their teleporter down. We really need a sentry gun down. That engineer is doing a great job. That engineer really set them up for success. But look at this. Because I'm using the black box conch and now I do have a medic attached to me. Thank you, medic. I'm staying on the cart and actually able to hold this cart. We might have lost just then if I was not a black box conch right then. It could have been game over, man. We wouldn't even be sitting here having this conversation now, would we? Demo man, yes, I love you. Let's get this. Oh, couldn't kill off the medic. Sounds like the medic did go down to someone else, though. But let's get this teleporter. Yes, no more teleporter, no more engineer. 3.5 left. We might actually hold this now. Crutch items. These aren't crutch items. These are clutch items. If you use them right. So don't just see these items and feel the need that you need to install someone. I don't even know where this mentality even came into Team Fortress 2, that you see someone using a loadout, that loadout kills you somehow, so you feel the automatic need or the automatic justification to fling insults at them. Just because. Man, they're just items in the game. If the items are overpowered, they need to be nerfed, okay? That's without a doubt. Looks like that spy might have changed from a dead ringer to something else, because I didn't hear a loud decloak on him. And is that a spy? He's moving like a spy. I don't trust him. It looked like I had a rocket impact on him. See, he was a spy. Wait a minute. So tell me your thoughts, okay? Because this is my mindset on it, and I'm not the only... I'm not the ruler of thoughts here in Team Fortress 2. I definitely have a casual mindset when it comes to gaming in Team Fortress. I don't take it too seriously. Use whatever you want. I don't care if I die to something really, really bizarre. I tend not to think that there's any items that is really overpowered. And when I see nerfs happen to classes like my spy, I do get upset because, you know, I've just learned to deal with whatever it is that's coming at us. If there's a Ubered Pyro, if there's a jetpack they decide to give the Pyro, that's perfectly fine. I'll deal with it. But just berating people for using a loadout that has synergy? I mean, this loadout has synergy. The conch with the black box is a very selfish loadout, right? Yes, the soldier is looking to just heal himself. You don't really use your conch to heal teammates, but you're helping them out by staying alive, staying persistent, killing the enemy, defending the cart. I don't know. Let me know your thoughts on it. I just find that there's a really strange click or habit in a Team Fortress community to fuss at stuff. And each class has it. Each class has something that is in their loadout that people have decided that because this weapon is different, it puts the weapons on a scale, and unless you're using the most optimal of all the loadouts, then you're using it as a crutch, or because the loadout has good synergy, you're using it as a crutch. 10 seconds left, making sure nothing comes close to the cart. Nothing back there, we are good. So thanks for watching, I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Try not to be mean to your other Team Fortress 2 players, because they could go elsewhere. Non più dry farfalon amoroso, notte giorno.
giorno di torno girano delle belle turbando al riposo. Ma ci sei tu a dolcino d'amor, delle belle turbando al riposo. Ma ci sei tu a dolcino d'amor.